A clear view of performance metrics makes assessing and improving service quality and efficiency much easier. Let me show you how to build a service dashboard. Hi, Matt Barron, Product Specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Service Desk, you can build a centralized view of department, team, or specific metrics performances. Before we get started, you can always grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along. You should also find a link in the description. Whether you need to assess current performance, share your measurements with leadership, or just inform your own decisions, a dashboard is a great way to bring the data to the forefront of your attention. The basic elements of our dashboard system are found along the top of our dashboards. From a dashboard selector here, showing both pre-built and customized dashboards, in here you can choose to make the dashboard your default view, share it with other people in your business, make a copy or delete each of your dashboards. For pre-built templates down below, you just have the option of making it your default and, of course, to copy it. It should be noted here that if you are sharing a dashboard with others, it doesn't require that they have a license of InvGate Service Desk, but it does require that they have access to the information on the dashboard. For instance, unless explicitly granted, a member from the HR Service Desk will only see dashboard results for that HR Service Desk team. Until they're granted observer rights to another team, they won't see any other team's work on their dashboard. So if you're sharing marketing team metrics with the marketing department, just make sure that they have access to that data first. You can also start from scratch by clicking on the plus sign right here. This will create a blank dashboard. The remaining options of our dashboard features are over here on the right. You can export our dashboards, filter them, set up auto refresh so that it refreshes every 5 minutes, and you can make the dashboard full screen. The full screen option is great if you've got a TV or a projector or somewhere where you want to display your key metrics. It should also be noted that when you are working on a dashboard itself, you can actually make the individual metrics appear on their own as a full screen item as well. So here I can blow this up and see in much greater detail each of the help desk names that make up this pie chart. Very useful features. Each dashboard is also able to filter. So if I want to, I can say, just show me specific help desks. Like if I just want to see the IT help desks, it's going to give me a much different picture of the work that we're doing. Another thing you might do is just want to see a specific timeline. So now just show me tickets specifically that were created this year. And now it's just showing me a subset of the data that I have access to. Once you've got a blank dashboard or a dashboard that you want to copy, you can go ahead and hit copy. So here I'm going to copy the backlog default dashboard, and I'm just going to call this my team backlog. Now I'm going to make this my team backlog my default. So now it's my default screen. I'm just going to hit dashboard. It's going to load my team backlog, and now I can go ahead and customize this dashboard. So to do that, I'm going to click on this edit icon here. Once editing, you can change the name and description of the dashboard, which is very useful as you change it. I should also note that you can add a custom filter here. Now, this filter doesn't appear to your dashboard viewers. So I usually recommend that if you are filtering for a specific team or timeline, that you then put that team name or timeline in the name of the dashboard or in the description of the dashboard so people know what they're seeing. Next, for laying out the dashboard, we made it easy for you to move these individual widgets on each row, and you're able to swap rows too. So if I want to move this one up here, I can. All you need to do is drag on these handles. And each widget then, once we're in edit mode, you can see they can be set to wide. So for instance, on this one, I might want this one to show a little wider so I can see all those names. I also have the option to set these to be three-dimensional or two-dimensional. Just gives it a little personal look and feel. There's a configuration icon here, and you can delete the widgets. So if you just don't want this here, you can just hit delete. And if you want to bring it back, you can hit the plus sign here to add the widget back. Now, when configuring, you'll see lots of different ways to manage your data. So for instance, I'll take this request by type widget, and I'm going to go into the configuration options on it. Now, this screen is pretty self-explanatory. This widget is showing requests by type with no drill down. So if I want to change this, I might want to switch this. I might want to see, since this is my team, I might want to see instead of type, probably I want to see which agent is assigned to requests. So now I can see my team's work and how many requests are assigned to each person, or at least the percentage. Now I might want to drill in. Let's say that I'm working on agent performance. If I want to drill into these, I might want to drill into, say, the SLA. You know, are they meeting the SLAs, for example? So now I'm going to switch it so that when I do click on one of these pie pieces, then it's going to zoom in and then it's going to give me that agent's status of SLAs for their tickets. Now, you can see right away that our widget builder is giving us a preview every time we change the stuff over here. So if I change this to say columns, it changes in a preview format. So I can kind of see what I'm getting. You can see we've got lots of different options for visualizing this work. To be honest, I do think that pie makes the most sense for this. So I'm just gonna keep it pie. You can also add a set of filters over here. So this right now is showing all of my teams, all my agents across all of my teams. Maybe I want to show something very specific. I can actually say, you know, just show me tickets where the creation date is on or before. And now we'll just say January 1st. And this is just gonna show last year's tickets. There are lots of reasons why you would want to use this. I don't want this on this widget, so I'm just going to hit save, and then we can see our results. So here is the widget as we configured it. And when I click on, say, Pete Davidson's tickets here, I can zoom in and see that Pete has hit a third of his tickets and missed two thirds of his tickets SLAs. So just a real simple way to customize a dashboard to get the information that you need. Now, these charts are very useful, and a lot of the stuff that we've pre-built is very useful for what it says it's for. You may need to customize, beg, borrow, and steal from other good practices to build some great widgets. You can see on our backlog report, though, we do have some pretty useful ones like request by category, and my personal favorite, the backlog per month. This trend chart is very useful at telling me, hey, our backlog used to be only 34 tickets and now it's 43. It looks like it's continuing to increase. So hopefully you can see that it's very useful to see your information this way and make informed decisions instead of just guessing off of gut feeling. And this is just one aspect of InvGate Service Desk that's designed to make a leader's job easier, to help inform our decisions instead of just depending on gut feeling. For more on this topic, subscribe to our YouTube channel or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.